Hi, I'm Dr. Joe Nemeth. I'm a periodontist in Southfield, Michigan, and I want to talk a little bit about the transmissibility or the contagiousness of gum disease, because I was asked recently, is gum disease contagious? I call it transmissible. Well, yeah, it is transmissible, mainly through saliva. So if someone has gum disease, and someone who doesn't kisses that person, they can get those organisms from that person who has gum disease. Even if it's not just kissing, but anything that has that person's saliva, eating utensil, toothbrush, anything that might have that patient's or that person's saliva has the organisms that cause gum disease and can be transmitted to whoever is exposed to that saliva. So it's very, very transmissible. But here's something interesting. Even though it's transmissible, that doesn't necessarily mean the person who is exposed to those organisms will get periodontal disease or gum disease, because some people are resistant to those bacteria and some people are susceptible to those bacteria. So let me give you an example. I was just telling some people, this is a great example. So let's say there's 100 people in a room and a young boy or a young girl comes in with a bad, bad cold. And all of these 100 people are exposed to this person with a bad cold. Now, some of these people are going to catch that cold. And in some cases, that cold may progress to bronchitis and maybe even pneumonia. Some people will get a cold like that child's cold. Some people will get a milder cold and some people won't get a cold at all. Well, why is that? Because some people are resistant and some people are susceptible. What's the same thing with gum disease? Some people are resistant, some people are susceptible. Most people fall within those two extremes. So gum disease is caused by bacteria, but the most important thing is try to make sure that your mouth is clean and healthy and free of those bacteria, because even if you don't have gum disease that's causing bone loss, if you have the organisms in your mouth and it's not causing bone loss, that doesn't mean that they're not getting into your bloodstream and affecting the rest of your body, like now a likely causative factor for Alzheimer's disease, as well as a significant relationship between heart disease, cardiovascular disease, stroke that is, kidney problems, now pancreatic cancer, diabetes. There's almost no disease or part of your body that is not negatively impacted by the organisms that cause gum disease, even if you're not having active gum disease, if the organisms are there. So this looks like a healthy mouth. This is not such a healthy mouth, and that's obvious. It's got gum recession and bone loss. So this is, you know, this would be an extreme case of gum disease, but we've seen patients whose mouth looks just like this. It looks very healthy, looks great, but then when we take x-rays, we find that almost all the bone is gone. So even though the mouth looks good and the gums look good, that doesn't indicate what may be going on deep under the gum. Anyway, the important thing here is make sure that you keep your mouth healthy, because if you have a healthy mouth, you're going to have a healthier body. I guarantee it, it's absolutely certain. So we welcome questions, comments, subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'd love to hear from you and have a great day.
Restore your smile and your health. Visit drnemeth.com to schedule your appointment today.